Hello, this is Boyan from Bengard Computer Systems. Today we will look at a high-level comparison between Sage Intacct Construction and Sage 300 CRE applications. We will review technology behind these two applications, program architecture, user interface and user experience, and feature parity. Sage Intacct Construction is a cloud-based enterprise resource planning system that offers a suite of applications for finance and operations. It's offered as a service, SaaS. It is through cloud solution where clients only require a computer, PC or Mac, web browser, and internet connection to access their ERP system 24/7. All users, all clients, access Sage Intacct by a common business layer, which means that all users of the system are always running on the same program version. That greatly simplifies upgrades, technical support process, and introduces additional level of security and certainty for regularly scheduled 4 releases per year. Business layer is based on a robust and scalable multi-tenant platform, which ensures top performance. Stats are showing that Intacct has 99.97% of uptime. Intacct also offers powerful web services platform, which enables integration with wide selection of applications via open API. Sage 300 CRE, on the other side, is based on a totally different technology stack. 300 CRE is a two-tier server-client application where the first tier, which is the server side of application, database engine, and data, are all running on the application server. The second tier is the client side, which runs application on a client workstations. Connections between a server and clients is made over local area network, LAN, and all the hardware is typically located on premises. All security and disaster recovery risks are managed internally. The second option of deploying Sage 300 CRE is to have it hosted in data center. That does not change application architecture at all. It only changes the method of accessing the application. Clients would typically connect to the VPN appliance of some sort just to secure access to the host's firewall, and from there they would connect to the server via remote desktop terminal services. The benefits of this type of deployment is that it eliminates the need for on-premise hardware, it benefits from the host provider's hardware and a backup redundancy system. From the security point of view, on Sage Intacct side, cloud services is a highly regulated industry. Data and privacy is protected with the top-tier policies and adherence to all regulatory requirements. On the other side, two-tier infrastructure, it's not really regulated, it's contractual. Data security and privacy protection depends on the policies of IT services providers. Multi-tenancy, as we said before, all customers are running on the same version of the same base code. It enables seamless upgrades and allows solution to be both configurable and scalable. On the other side, Sage 300 CRE, being typical two-tier server client architecture, the database engine and database files and business layer are all hosted on a server. Upgrades are performed individually for each client. On API and integration topic, the True Cloud solution provides APIs to easily integrate with other True Cloud solutions. On the other side, Sage 300 CRE, we have a limited integration possibilities. Most of data exchange is done by export-import of CSV files. From the architecture point of view, let's look at a few key points. On the client side, again, we discussed Sage Intacct. Really, there is no client. There is a PC or Mac connected to the internet and using browser to access application. On the server side, there are dedicated capacity separated from API and offline application server pools, which results in optimized performance. On 300 CRE side, resources are not dedicated specifically for integration and offline tasks. Therefore, performance might be affected by integration and offline tasks. For web services and API, reserved application server capacity to support high-level concurrency exists in a Sage Intacct. Therefore, we have dedicated queues just for integration processes. On 300 side, there are no web services. They are not applicable. And there are limited integration options via API. Therefore, integration tasks can potentially impact performance. And finally, offline scheduled jobs. There's also reserved application server capacity for offline jobs such as report generation and delivery in Intacct, resulting in dedicated queues, therefore improved performance. On CRE side, there are no dedicated server capacity for macros, which are typically used for report generation, etc. They need to be scheduled to run after hours in order not to have negative impact on performance. Therefore, performance might be affected by running those scheduled jobs in Sage 300 CRE. Next, we're going to look at user interface and user experience and feature parity. So let's compare two systems from user interface and user experience perspective. On the left-hand side, we have Sage Intacct, and on the right-hand side, we have Sage 300 CRE. You will notice that we can set up both systems based on user preferences to have our particular dashboards as a landing page for each user. So when I open a system, system can open the dashboard that's set up in my user preference. On the Intacct side, the system comes with a built-in dashboard designer that can use different widgets, such as scorecards, views, charts, and allow user to combine those different components, different views, and create a dashboard through the dashboard designer. Also, dashboards on a Intacct side interactive in a way that values are enabled for drill downs. So if I click on this particular value, for instance, it will take me to the detailed version of the report. And then from there, I can drill down to original transaction from another hyperlink. So I can get to the core transaction by using a simple drill down clicks to get to the bottom of that particular inquiry. On a Sage 300 CRE side, though, dashboards are designed using Crystal Report Designer. They're a little bit more static. Crystal reports do allow creation or design of sub-reports within the main report, which allows us to drill down to a certain extent. So we can drill down one level, so get from main report to open invoices in this particular case, but no further drill downs is available. Also, to design or to make changes to existing dashboard designs, users would have to have a Crystal Report Designer available and would have to know how to use it. We can also review typical data entry screens such as bills and accounts payable in Intacct. That correlates to AP invoices in Sage 300 CRE. So let's open a AP invoice task, enter invoices in Sage CRE on the right-hand side. And on Intacct side, let's open a screen that will allow us to enter the invoice. So differences in design itself are obvious. Flexibility of the forms, functionality of the forms, user interaction with the forms will generate totally different user experience. Forms in Sage CRE are not resizable. That's another point that I'd like to make here. You can change one dimension, but really you cannot stretch screens beyond limitation of the form itself. On Intacct side, we have way more flexibility in terms of interaction with the users, searchability, availability of help menus on a different items, common use of common dropdowns, shortcuts or hotkeys, and the forms is also available. So totally different user experience when it comes to the typical data entry screens. From reporting perspective and capabilities, on Sage Intacct side, we have dashboard designer, financial designer, custom report writer, an interactive custom report writer, which is used for more sophisticated, complicated type of reports. On a CRE side, we have RD report designer. We can use a Crystal Reports to design reports or client-facing documents. We have financial statement designer and inquiry designer. The major difference, though, is that is application of financial statement designer between two systems. In Intacct, having a different dimensions available in GL, dimensions being a project, cost code, employees, customers, vendors, we can report on that type of data from the GL as well. So a financial statement designer in Intacct can be used to create, let's say, project overview report. On a CRE side, though, financial statement designer is used for typical GL type of reporting, balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statement, etc. Intacct reports are also drill down enabled. So natively, we can drill down on values displayed on the reports and get to the core transaction. On CRE side, that is very limited. It's limited to inquiries. And to the certain level with Crystal Reports, we can have a sub-reports that will take us to the next level. But drilling down to the core application, to the original transaction, it is a little bit challenging task in a CRE. And finally, let's look at the comparison between applications available in two systems. If I drop down a list of applications in Intacct, also known as Application Picker, I need to mention that this list is somewhat misleading because it does not include all options and features and applications available through integration or being limited to my licensing structure here. So applications such as fixed assets, property management, service management are not on a list as I'm showing it on the screen, but they are available. On CRE side, however, this is pretty much a screen of all available applications in a system. Really, the only one where I can find a major difference between two systems is equipment costing. So CRE does have equipment cost module for equipment cost and revenue tracking, which currently is not available in a Sage Intacct. However, given dynamic of marketplace and a very aggressive development roadmap of Intacct, I'm fairly certain that those options will be available in Intacct fairly soon. So this was our high-level overview comparison between Sage Intacct Construction and Sage 300 CRE. Thank you for watching.